Hello everyone and welcome to a new Legacy video. I'm playing today Legacy for Chan Fireball YouTube channel, and the deck I have in front of me, you might think it's a modern deck because we're playing with Sigarda's Aid, we're playing with Colossus Hammer, but instead it's not modern Mono White Hammer, you know, one of the best decks in the format. We're porting that over to Legacy. You might ask me, what are the cards that let you go Legacy instead of Modern? Well, actually not that many. You have Mox Opal, you have Ancient Den, you have Umezawa's Jit, as well as Caracas. So mostly this is a Modern deck, trying to porting that over to Legacy. Very often I ask people ask me about, quote-unquote budget options to get into Legacy. And well, this is basically a Modern deck with very few cards. Addition. So, all right. What does this deck try to do? Well, for those of you who don't know about Modern Hammer, you have both Sigarda's Aid and Pure Steel Paladin to equip your Colossus Hammer, and this is gonna give the creature +10/+10 and lose flying, meaning that Incomoth Nexus will be lethal. Meaning that Ornithopter and Esper Sentinel, you have even Ingenious Myth as a card advantage engine. You have Stoneforge Mystic, very important to tutor up your armor. And then again, you have the Paladin to equip the armor. You're playing also Kaja Complete as a sort of Enlightened Sash, as a sort of mid-range plan. The sideboard, we have the March, couple of Spirit of the Labyrinth, very good in Legacy. We also have the Phoenix Silence, good in Legacy, Leyline, Graftigus Cage, and a couple of Plows. This deck was made by streamer Spider Space, and I like to play some brews for my Legacy videos. This video is sponsored to you by channelfireball.com and Ultimate Guard. Remember that Channel Fireball is the place to go if you want to read about all the competitive Magic content. So if you want to read the guide about Modern Hammer, there is plenty of those there, and Ultimate Guard is the place to go to protect your cards. And they have launched their new Perfect Sleeve, the new Inner Sleeves, Katana Inner Sleeve, so definitely check them out. Good morning, Snap Booster. Have a nice week to you too. Okay, we're beginning here. I am on the play. Okay, this end isn't bad. I'm gonna keep this end. I am going to keep this end. I'm gonna go land Colossus Armor or Nithopter as well. I wonder if I should go Nexus here, because the Nexus might be lethal actually next turn. So I'm gonna go Nexus here. And also Ornithopter, why not? So that next turn I can play a Pure Steel Paladin, a second hammer, and equip them all to just Ornithopter and attack. I will play Ornithopter here, but I will pass the turn afterwards. I don't want to go Mox Opal Hammer as well, because I might draw a card if I play next turn with a Pure Steel Paladin. Okay. Strong end gear. Of course, the power of Mox Opal is very important. You have Mox Opal in Modern, it's just they cost one mana, it's called Springleaf Drum. Okay, when it goes Ponder, remember that in this format there is a Force of Will, but there isn't Solitude, meaning that people don't play it. So there isn't a free removal spell, but again, Force of Will. Okay, put in Shuffle the library. Stoneforge Mystic. Okay, I'm gonna go Plains, Mox Opal, Pure Steel Paladin here. Let's see if they have a Force of Will. They do. Pitching, Tronium Nemesis. Okay. I do not think I want to play another Hammer, so I'll just pass. Tronium Nemesis isn't a very common played card. I'm gonna hold this in hand because of Sigarda's Aid. Sigarda's Aid reward you for holding the Hammer in your hand. So there, if my opponent didn't have a Force of Will, I would have won the game. But I mean, Legacy is like that. People win games on two, but the Force of Wills is what reigns supreme at the end. That's okay. Draw.
Plains. Okay, not bad. I'll play a Stoneforge Mystic. Let's see what happens here. Opponent's probably playing some sort of removal spells deck. So I don't think I want to get the Cadre Complete here. Forceful again, pitching days. All right. Important that we played around this. Okay, they got three cards in and only, and nothing that stands out. So even though we also have nothing that stands out, it's okay, we can play here. All right, let's see, this could be a Merc that region 6/6. That would be a problem, of course. The problem, unless I draw exactly Sigarda's Aid, then it's no problem. Draw. To-do, Sigarda's Aid. Sigarda's Aid for Mengu, please. Plains. Plains is not a Sigarda's Aid. I'll pass the turn. I will pass the turn indeed here. Good morning. Okay, opponent's fetching with two cards in their hand. Is this what, a Teferi Time Raveler? This could be the Jeskai Delver deck that I played with last week. So if you're interested in my opponent's deck, you can check out the last video for Channel Fireball that I made about Jeskai Delver and Legacy won the challenge in the hands of True Hero. Thank you to Guren S. Appreciate the sub. Ooh, look at this draw here. Not bad. Let's play Stoneforge Mystic. Thank you, Guren S. How's it going? All right, what do I get with this now? Lots of options. Can Umezawa's Jit compete with my opponents going on here? I don't think so. But maybe it is. Yeah, I think it's probably the best options I got here. And I'm even playing it. The opponent has one card in it. If they have days, well, it's very bad for me. But if they don't have days, next turn I get two mana in case I draw something. Like, I'm gaining two mana for the next turn. Here I can chum block with the Thopter. We'll see. We will see. I mean, at the end of the day, it is a close call here. I can also just take six down to eight and keep the creatures to keep with the Jit. Because next turn, maybe I can, like, I don't know, in two turns, maybe grow my Jit, grow my Thopter to a 6/8. Anyway, Sigarda's Aid is always the best draw here. Mox Opal, it's not a good draw, unfortunately. All right, let's put the Jit on the Stoneforge and let's attempt to attack here, growing the Jit to two counters. Of course, if opponent has Lightning Bolt or, you know, anything of that sort, it's very annoying. Also, if I want to chum block, I'd rather chum block with a Thopter with counters on it. That plows. Yep. And once again, I don't want to chum block with the Thopter because I want to give myself the window to win the game if I draw Sigarda's Aid. Whereas if I chum block, I don't have any... If I chum block, I don't have any outs. Okay? So you have to think about that when playing Magic. You can't just chum block and leave yourself with, like, I don't know what I'm drawing, you know? I'm not in a great shape, but still gotta play for your outs. You're keeping this does literally nothing because this is no power, so the chase will never get counters. But regardless of that, yeah. And the Thopter will lose flying if you put a hammer on it, except that with Sigarda's Aid, you can equip the Thopter after attacks. Sorry, after blocks. So the opponent cannot block with a ground creature, and then you put a hammer on it. So it loses flying, but doesn't really matter. Hello, Nova Scotia. Good morning. Thank you again, Guren S, for the sub as my opponent ponders their way. But then again, the turn two force of will was crucial for my opponent survivorship on the Paladin. My starting hand was very good. And even the Mox Opal, of course, was very important to get there. Okay, my opponent this time does not shuffle. Again, we can't chum block. Okay, I would chum block with this. Yeah. Sorry, not chum block, but block. Okay, so here I got a three. But then again, that bolt light eye, so no reason to play around bolt. Draw Sigarda's Aid. Stoneforge Mystic again. Unfortunately, think I can survive, but maybe. No, I think I actually can survive here. I'm gonna get Shadow Spear. I'm gonna put it on the Thopter. Right? Can give one up to four and only lose three. Yeah, I'm survivor. I am survivor. All right, I'm a survivor, chat. Look at this. I'm gonna put Shadow Spear. I'm gonna play Mox Opal. It's legendary. And then I'm going to equip this here. And I wonder if I should attack or not. Oh, yeah, another plow. All right, then. Okay, good game. Hello, the Divine Tutors. Has anyone made a wrong Q joke yet? Not yet. Must say that first spell we played was Mox Opal, so it can't really be the wrong Q. Okay, I want the Spirit of the Labyrinth and I want the Plows. I don't want Ley Lines. I'm not one of those Ley Line against the Elber players. If you're one of those, I respect you, but I'm not one of those. So obviously we need to be worried about Meltdown on top of everything else here. So I'm certainly cutting these three. Maybe cutting also Kadra complete. No. I'll keep that in. Maybe just a Thopter. Yeah, just trimming on those zeros. Pause sideboard. Good morning, the broker. Okay, I'm on the play. Yes. Of course, like, as you can see here, having Kadra complete in hand is like a mulligan index without brainstorms. But at the same time, I think I'm keeping this hand. It's only one lander, but we do play 22, and we have a specific on the play, so I feel like this is a keep. Also, Mox Opal is an out, so we have basically like 24 lands in our deck. 21 lands and 3 Mox Opal, so I'm feeling like this is a keep here. Putting goes force of foot on the Sentinel. Pitching Murta Regent. Alright then. No reason to play the Thopter here. Since even if I draw a hammer, I can't go Sigarda's 8 hammer. Buongiorno. Okay. We are seeing a lot of Force of Wills. That's definitely the name of the format. Force of Will Wasteland Days are the cards that dictate the format. Then, of course, you have Ponder and Brainstorm. You can also say that those are iconic, but at the end of the day, Ponder and Brainstorm are like, you know, just cantrips, whereas the rest are actually cards that make you a little bit upset. All right. Let's try to play a Sigarda's Aid. Unfortunately, no land to go turn to Stoneforge Mystic. Here, I should have definitely played Ornithopter, because if I draw a hammer, I can put it on it. My mistake. And this deck plays in the top 16 of a Legacy Showcase, so it's definitely capable of beating the best decks in the format. How did Legacy event go? Yeah, yesterday I held a Legacy tournament at my town. 24 people arrived, which is a pretty cool number, since lots of people from other towns as well. It's very, very happy with it. Okay, second Sigarda's 8 after they ended the first one. I personally, the top 8, lost to Legacy GP winner Claudio Bonanni. Funny how in the 24 people were like multiple Legacy GP top 8, Ovinato winners, Four Seasons winners, and things like that. Not that many Legacy players around, but definitely very good ones. All right, do I draw land here? I do. Very nice. Let's go. Stoneforge Mystic then. And the cool thing of this is if I take a hammer here, opponent will never kill the Stoneforge because, you know, I just have a hammer in hand. Instead, what I have is a Kadra complete. So my opponent will not kill the Stoneforge and boom, I'll just play a Kadra complete. So that's a big deal. Is it taught in St. Gallia? Very much. Yep. And my loss in the top 8, I was playing 8 cast Mon Blue Artifacts. I lost to 4 color with Minsk and Boo, 3 copies. That deck won the event. Got some big regrets for game 2 and 3, but you know, those like magic plays where you're unsure, you make a choice, and it ends up being not ideal, and then you like think about what could have done different, and you actually find some lines that maybe would have won you the game, and you like think about those, and you know, classic magic. Anyway, opponent brainstorms, so they're sculpting their hand with removal spells. Hopefully though, they let me untap with both of these so I can put the Kaja complete. And once this is in play, I mean, against Blue Red Delver, this is very good. Against my opponent's deck, they have Plows, so it's gonna be less good. Less good. I could move the Kaja complete with something like Sigarda's Aid, but it's not worth it. I don't wanna lose the Germ. And then opponent just, ooh, Wasteland. Yep, sometimes Caracas is worse than Abyssic Plains. Actually, very often. Draw. Land. Nice. Ancient Din. Alright. Let's put it to play the complete. Again, I'm not doing anywhere. Sigarda's Aid. I guess it's a May, right? Yeah. I'll put it on here. Maybe they have to bolt this. They should have thought it, but okay. Attack for 5. Haste. Hasta. And this is also indestructible. Again, Prismatic Ending deals with this, but the most normal Delver list, they don't play with white. So usually Kaja Complete is a very good thing. You need Caracas in the form of a Mirrored Leash, that's true. Mozzie, thank you so much. Let's say most consistent content creator, thank you. Mystic Sanctuary, you can put on top log and kill that, boom, boom, boom. We do have Amarina, the opponent knows about this, so they need another bolt for the Stoneforge. They get Ending, okay. So Ending is on top now. What do? Iteration? Okay, actually the list that won the challenge was not playing Iteration. That was one of my biggest complaint about that list, is that didn't have Sanctuary nor Iteration. This player, VCF, I guess it's just playing a different list. Splashing White for the powerful Exile effects. You get a little bit worse in mana base, of course, because you have to add an additional color, but just White is so powerful in Legacy. Both White and Green are definitely, you kind of need those to be blue-red. White for the Exile effect and Green for the... Okay, now... Is my opponent just dead here? I guess they have a Forceful Mirehammer. I'm still casting this. Because I can't violate it because I need to attack here. I think we win. Ta-ta-da! Alright, cool. Good game. Hammer. Boom-boom. My opponent forgot about that we took Hammer with the Stoneforge because we had this in hand. Again, that's the little nice thing. So I said at the beginning this was a mulligan. It clearly wasn't. It won us the game, drawing Kaja Complete in our opening end. Because sometimes you bait your opponent into thinking that you actually don't have it. So they don't play around it and you win. Okay, the Wildlander worked out. Of course, we needed to draw a couple of lands to be able to play our spells, but you don't always have to. Oh, I forgot we had Urza Saga in our deck. That's a nice card to have. Okay, yeah, this is clearly a keep here. Ancient Den will let us activate the Saga on turn 2. Yeah, I think I'll play Saga. I don't want to play Hammer, though. I'll just play Saga. Because I can go... actually, I have to go Hammer if I want to activate the Saga turn 2. And pass. As if they exile my Hammer with a Prismatic Ending. Nope. Oh, Stoneforge Mystic. I misunderstood my opponent deck, I guess. They're also on that plane. What do they get? They get the complete. We got a Plow for that, though. All right, draw. Okay, second Mox Opal. Sweet. I can go Mox Opal, Ancient Den, and then I can make a token with the Urza's Saga. Unfortunately, no. No Sigarda Zed or Piercy Paladin yet to equip our armor. But yeah, I mean, these two cards are currently banned in Modern, both Muxopa and Ancient Dead. So this is really a combination that you can only do in Legacy. Okay, put it to no Wastelands. That's good for me. They go ending on the armor. I have to float mana with this. And I guess I have to make a token now. And I'm gonna just put the complete. All right, sure. What do I want to do here? Maybe I can get Shadow Spear. It depends on what I draw, of course. If I draw a Paladin, maybe I get a Hummer. We'll see. Draw, another land. Okay. I can make a token. I think I like making a token here. I'll make a token. Pick up Shadow Spear. Then I can go just land plow. Nah, I can daze this. Maybe I can go Urza Saga, Mox Opal, plow. Think I like that. That way I play around daze and I let Saga around. Or actually, I can just equip the Shadow Spear. Maybe that's better than killing the Kadra Complete tokens. Think so, yeah. This way I'll also play around, Dress Down, because one of the constructs will be equipped, so it doesn't let you Dress Down. Yeah, that's attack for 6 life link here. I also use better my mana base. And that's the famous one-man army of Shadow of Urza Saga, 2 5/5s. And a Shadow Spear, just with one card. Very powerful tool in the format with Mox Opal and Artifact Lands. This is what you do in the mono blue artifacts that I love to play. Shadow Spear sometimes, just again with Seat of Cyanide and Mox Opal, you just get these board states. Of course, that can go Meltdown. Unfortunately, not much I can do about that. Nah, I mean, straight up lose to Meltdown. And that's okay. You have to kind of embrace that when you play these decks. It's, you know, either you play a blue deck that, you know, doesn't really suffer any cards. Actually, you do. The Carpet of Flowers. Ooh, Stone is Silent. Oh, no. Stone is Silence. Can I get my March of the Otherworldly Light now, please? Putting 3 cards in it. And now I can't tap my Mox Opal and my Ancient Dead anymore. And I can't move the Shadow Spear anymore. Pure Steel Paladin. Okay. I'm gonna go Plains Swords. Hoping they don't have a force in their 3 cards. That force, Pitching Brainstorm. The way the Kadra Complete Germ works is first strike, and when it touches a creature, it exiles it. So I have no. I have no wind to attack here. Is there anything I can tutor up that's relevant? I don't think there is. I guess I can get a Hummer and then Paladin can I keep here, but no, still, first strike will kill me first. The Shadow Spear makes this creature lose indestructible, but still the first strike plus exile effect will be deadly. When it puts back on top, probably a Prismatic Ending. That's true, can't keep a Paladin in a way. Yeah, no. Again, I mean, this is no Meltdown, but as efficient. Maybe I would have a chance if my opponent didn't have force on the and was able to attack for 11 last turn. Maybe I would have had a chance. Do we have Aether Spell Bomb? But we do not. This is a mono white deck. If you go exclamation mark deck or from computer, you're able to see the deck lists. Deck list. It's one. Also, Spellbomb is off because of Stone Silence. That's true. Yeah, we can make a bunch of constructs, and that's my goal. Yeah. Although my opponent has a prismatic ending in end or on top, I don't know what did I do with this. Oh, say it's exiled. Cool. So I can cast the ending now, exiling. I'm assuming this construct here, since the Shadow Sphere cannot be activated. Yep. Draw. I can't make a token with Saga because I can't use my artifacts because of Stony Silence. So I'll simply float mana. I'll play Urza Saga and I'll attack for 5. Yesterday, I lent Mono Blue, 8 cast to a friend of mine, and he managed to beat Energy Flux, the one that you have to pay to every upkeep. He did that with Kappa Cannoneer. This seems a little bit harder now. Still no chum block. This creature has trample, so. I mean, technically, next turn I'll make another construct. And then the turn after I'll make another construct. Murky boy. Big boy, murky boy. And I got one card in end. No cards in end. Lots of people there. I'll pass. All right, let's see how they attack here. I can't win if they play well. I have to hope they make some sort of mistakes, which doesn't look like they do. And again, this is like unblockable, basically. Huh. All right, good game, yeah. No business about this game, unfortunately. Okay, this is a good end for round number 2. We got both Tegazaid, we got Hummer, great. If I was in the play, it would have been better, but can't complain. Tundra go, nice. I'll simply start with the Esper Sentinel. I think this is the best way to start for this deck. Put us playing Yorin. Is that maybe some sort of actually here, I think I should play Thopter as well, because if one kills my Sentinel, next turn I can go Sigarda's 8 armor attack for 10. If I don't play the Thopter, I can't do that, so I think it's good. Buongiorno, Librarian. Esper Strix. That's alright. I don't have Trample though. And the Strix has Deathwish. Strix is not legal in Modern. Has never been printed in a normal set. Unlike Charles Agent from the same... Charles Agent was from the same set as Wheel of Strix. Plane Chase, I believe. Alright, what about if I go Stoneforge Mystic for Kadra here? So let me just for... What about Stoneforge Mystic for Shadow Spear instead? I do want to play Stoneforge Mystic. See if it resolves. It does. Cool. Now, if I get Shadow, Cosmic Blade might be a waste of a slot. But at the same time, opponent's playing. I should just get Shadow Spear here. I like to get Trample to my Colossus Armor creatures. Yeah, of course, I'm not attacking. Go. Yeah, right now all the cards that they have are Modern legal, so. Okay, that's cool. That's percentage. Taxing. Wow, they don't pay the tax. I guess they want to swords my sentinel, and they don't have a third land, so they didn't want to risk it. Maybe. Yeah, Strix is better than the Icefang Coatl, of course, but by not that much, that justifies not having this card in Modern Horizons 2. I'm actually curious if they tested or if they just didn't bother. Okay, Esper could be Sifite Breakfast. Could be the Cephalids. That's an 80 card deck with Yorion that can both grind and has a turn 2 combo as well. I've played it in one of my videos, so you can check it out. When is it you can check it out? It's very easy. You just go on YouTube search bar and just write deck name and my name, and something's probably going to pop up. Okay, cool. My opponent just plays a Baleful Strix and passes. Now, what you can do is I'll play Sigarda's Aedir. I'll play Inkmoth Nexus because this will be lethal next turn. And then what I want to do is I'll play Colossus Hammer. I want to see if they force this. They don't. I want to put it on the, because the opponent's going to block whatever I do, so I'm going to put it on the Thopter here, as well as the Shadow Spear, because giving trample is very important. All right. And then attack. I guess I could have done it in combat phase, but it's okay. I'm also attacking with the Stoneforge Mystic. Yep, I don't need the Stoneforge Mystic anymore. Opponent can kill us next turn. Double block, sure. Not sure why, but okay. Prevented one damage and didn't kill my Stoneforge. Sure, there's a reason, I just can't find it, but let's see if I'm dead here. You can't click and Cephalid Breakfast, Diego, Cephalid's Nomas, and you die. Or if they don't, I'm going to be able to put a Paladin and then equip the Nexus to kill my opponent. Ponder again. And even not paying the tax. I guess I might still want to combo off if they find what they need. Like they have Cephalids in hand, they need the Domads or Shuko and they kill me with a land, so. They don't shuffle, which is not a good sign. Please don't kill me. Stoneforge, I'm not dead. They have a one Tundra up, so that could be in a sort of supply shares, but it's gonna give me another card. Draw. Ooh, Pithing Needle. I could just name Cephalids with this. So here I'm gonna go Sentinel again. Pure Steel Paladin. Move the armor on Stoneforge Mystic, and also a Shadow Spear on a Stoneforge Mystic, and attack with a lethal threat. If they plow this, I draw two cards. They could play Solitude. That deck plays like one Solitude. All right, I plow, meaning that I draw two cards. Play Mox Opal. I'll play a Pithing Needle on Illusionist. Cephalid Illusionist. Let me double check it's the right card. You don't want to misclick on those. Cephalid Illusionist. Whenever it becomes. Actually, sorry. Sorry. I don't name this. I name Nobody Encore. Right? I should name this. The Cephalid doesn't have an activate ability. I want to name Shuko. You want to name Shuko here. Huh. Because you think if they didn't tutor it up, they already have it. I think I'm going to name Nomad. Nomad Encore. What's the name? Nomads and core. Nomads in core. And then I keep my sentinels because this way my opponent has to pay 11 and 2 instead of 1 and 1. Hello, Boston. How's it going? Would you keep Nexus to kill? I was already killing with this, so no reason to lose a land and two lands to do that. Despite we've been drawing two cards for the past, I don't know, two or three turns thanks to the Sentinel, opponents still got six cards. A Pithy Needle, hopefully zero annoying for them. They could still win if they go Cephalid plus Shuko. They play Tassa's Oracle, yes, yes. Again, if you don't know what my opponent deck is on, I'm sure I wrote and made videos in the highlights. I think there's even a deck guide by Rich Kali on Channel Fireball for the Cephalid's deck. All right, opponent passes with 4 mana up. That's a lot of mana up. Let me go Ingenious Myth here. See what happens. This happens. That's not bad. Now, right click on the Nexus to see this is the newly controlled, so you don't misclick. Activate this Nexus here. Then I am moving Shadow Spear onto this. So this is lethal. And then I'm attacking with all. You can't keep it instant speed with the Paladin. You can keep it instant speed with Sigarda's Aid, but not with the Paladin. Equipping is only an ability that you do in main phase. Unless, you know, you have some sort of effects. Sure. Wait a second. Oh, I don't have a block phase? Oh, chat, I don't have a block phase. I'm sorry, I didn't put the stop in the block phase. Ugh. All right, it's Ging, thank you for the 5th month. On Magic Online, you have to control all your steps, and for some reason, I guess I misclicked at some point and I didn't have the block phase step. It's usually never relevant. It was very relevant here. Well, okay. Sure. I don't kill my opponent here. Ooh. Okay, looks like it's not... The phase is not over yet, because that was just first strike damage. So I can still play a Colossus Armor. So let's do it. Because first strike happens and it's okay. Now, all these triggers arrive. I guess I'll put this last. Where do we put a counter on? Nexus? If they plow this, I'm fine. And they draw and pump this myth. Yep. Hello, it's Ging. Thank you again for the sub. Congrats on your RCQ win with Grixis Shadow. That's cool. They plow the Nexus. Do they pay the tax? They do. All right. Sure. Pump. Draw card. Oh, ho, nice, Mangu. Well done, Mangu. Well done, Mangu. We drew another Hammer off the Armor. Congrats. All right. You had one Snapcaster in the main? Cool. Yeah, Snapcaster. Underplayed modern card for sure. Okay, so I'm playing against Cephalids. Now the question, how many... So Gravedigger's Cage, of course, stops the combo because it stops the Dread Return. They reanimate the thing, so maybe it's worth adding. Spirit of the Labyrinth, I think it's worth adding against any blue deck. You called the Armor on top, did you? Nice. Thank you, QRE, for calling the right card on top of my deck. At the right time, too. I'm going to keep the Pithing Needle because Lion Slash also stops. Lion Slash also stops the combo. Maybe just sub like this. Two Spirit of the Labyrinth. I remove 2/2, drop for it. Cage, I think, is cool because we have Saga, and that's a way to stop my opponent combo. Lion Slash is low. Opponent, it's not the fastest deck. I mean, they could kill you on two, but as you saw, they can also just grind with Stoneforge and the other card. I'm missing colors. No, actually, never mind. I have Caracas. All right, then. Great. And let's go. Yeah, you have to play Pioneer, of course. That's the RCQ is Pioneer. Fine. Martyr of Runes. I'll go for a Sentinel. But I also want to go for a Thopter. I always want to kind of slow roll this because of the Ingenious Myth, right? At the same time, though, if I draw a Sigarda Zeta, I might want to attack with the Thopter. What's better? I think I'd rather slow roll the Thopter in case I draw Ingenious Myth. Which almost have a sin. Okay, they got Stoneforge. This deck had a top 16 in a showcase. It's been a deck that I always wanted to play, and on my legacy videos and channel Fireball, I like to bring new fun deck I see around. Okay, Druid's Saga, not bad. Although I think my hand is just good. I don't need to play it right now. Yeah, I don't need to play it right now. What do I want to play? Actually, since my opponent's playing a combo deck, and I do have like a card like Cage and Needle that stops my opponent combo, I think I'd rather do it. Do they have Kadra Complete? I can't get my own Kadra Complete because I set it out. Probably just gonna go... Oh, Stoneforge. For what though? I already have a Hammering Hand. This one can get Shadow Spear, but at the same time, I kind of want to take like a Hate Piece with the Saga and I get... Oh, they go Force. I draw a card. Okay. Maybe opponent isn't playing Shuko though, because they're playing Martyr of Runes. Does that deck play? I think I want to play a Thopter this time. Might save me one life. Hello, Sebastian. Will you talk about spoilers in the next podcast? Yes, for those of you who don't know it, I have a podcast now. Already recorded 2 episodes. The podcast is called Competitive Magic with the Carnies. You can find it on iTunes, Spotify, and hopefully soon on the other platforms as well. We'll be talking about previews, of course. Okay, Urza Saga. Urza Saga tokens is large here. I'm gonna play Ancient Den. I'm gonna start. Yeah, just making large tokens. Maybe the opponent is not Cephalids after all. The token is for now a 4/4. Next turn is gonna be very large. I can also get Mox Opal. I don't know, it depends what I draw, I guess. The Germ will keep on getting in and go to 10. Playing decks like this, both these, 8 cast and etc., you don't have Fetchland, so your life total is always very round at like 20. I guess 8 cast plays Ancient too, but this one does not. They only have 3 cards in hand. It's not that many. Modern of Runes is not like Giver. It doesn't protect from colorless. So the construct will... Okay, it is Cephalids with Nobas and Core. This card deals 1 damage to... Oh, I was like, exactly this. No, it's Narcomoeba. All right. You have Narcomoeba in your deck when you go off with Cephalids. So opponent has 1 card in hand. They clearly don't have the combo. So maybe I should just get Shadow Spear here. See what I draw. Okay, drawing needle means that I'm safe. Drawing needle means I'm safe. Now if I make a token, I can't equip the Shadow Spear, which I kind of want to do. I definitely want to, maybe I don't equip the Shadow Spear this turn, I'll do it next turn. So this turn, just make a token, tutor up a Shadow Spear, and just play Pithing Needle on Nomad's Encore. The turn after, I attack with the Shadow Spear. Yeah, I think it makes sense. What's wrong with this plan? What's wrong with this plan is that I'm losing a lot of, like, I could gain a lot of life this turn with a construct. The point is only one card in hand, so. The next one damage that will be dealt to the Nomad's Encore this turn is dealt to target creature you control instead. Okay. No, you know what? Change my mind. I'm just gonna just stop this saga. To drop the Shadow Spear. Yeah, just play things. Just play things. So, first, I'm going to equip this. Then, I'm going to play Esper Sentinel. And I guess I'm gonna play Pithing Needle first, because sometimes they play days in those decks. First day of holiday. All right. Enjoy your holiday, Wilbert. Opponent is on Sapphire Breakfast. Yes. Okay, let's go Needle once again on the Nomad's Encore. Put one card in it. Can't be days, can't be fours, because it's only one card. The Shutter Spear will be an 8-8. The Construct will be an 8-8. So opponent needs to stay back with a card. Nomad's Encore. Okay, and then I go Esper Sentinel, and that's half for 8. Pachew. 18 to 10, we switch our life total. We did Mirror Universe. Mirror Universe. And pass. Having to, remember, Shadow Spear has an important text. I guess it's not relevant. Again, we talked about this before. It removes indestructible, but I don't have like shatter effects. And this will remain with Death Touch and First Strikes. And it's not Death Touch, it's Pure Action Death Touch. I'd love to draw Paladin here. Paladin would be a very nice draw. They have the Moderate Runes. I don't know how relevant that is. Okay, they go ending where? On the Shadow Spear. Okay, sweet. I mean, not sweet. I'd rather they didn't, but they did. Jit is a card that's not. Jit and Ancient Den are both banned in Moderate right now. Okay. Graftigus Cage. Not the best. Not the best. I guess I'm still casting it because why not? Sneak Touch, like Aurum Viper. Okay. It's a good comparison. I'm going to play a Umezawa's Jit. One more prismatic ending, this time on the Umezawa's Jit. Interesting. Don't I play Arena anymore? I feel like every stream I have that question. No, I don't. I don't. It's been like an year or something. Maybe 6 months. Maybe four. I don't know. Time passes. Time passes fast. All right, I drew Spurs Labyrinth. Not bad. Well, actually, though, each player can draw more than one card each turn. Kind of awkward with Sentinels. Draw. Okay. I don't have anything to do. I will play a Spirit of the Labyrinth, though. I'll play Spirit of the Labyrinth because, well, put in place Ponder Brainstorms and I don't know, whatnot. There you go. Can't attack with the Nexus because they have Narc Amoeba. Maybe I should trade. I don't know. They can go Yorion here. Strix first, okay. They have zero cards in it. Ooh, they start attacking now. Fine. Draw. Okay. I'll play Foundry. I'll attack for 8. Opponent exiled both of my equipments. Equipments are what makes those games close, I think. And I pass. Rejuvenate Foundry can turn my top turn into a 4-4. And then I can untap this. Nah. Do I wanna do that? Do I wanna turn my top turn into a 4-4? Or do I wanna just make a servo here? What's more mana efficient? Maybe just a 4-4 is more bad. It's better. Yeah. Not using my mana well, but happy to get a 4-4. Tap with a construct. Oh, by the way, they played the Strix. They didn't draw a card. I didn't even think about that, but it did happen. Okay, start chum blocking. Fortunately, this PRX and Germ can't even be chum blocked. Very annoying. I got a 3. And then I'll have to block the Germ here. Still looking to draw a way to equip my Hummer. It's been 18 cards. I got 8. Make a servo. I'll untap the Foundry. And I'll make a Thopter with the servo. Fortunately, again, trample makes me really struggle. Draw. There's a saga. Not bad. Maybe a little bit too late, though. I'll probably play armor next turn. I can't keep it. Do I attack with the doctor? Think so. Nah. Yeah, I think so. So I could turn my doctor. See if they block. They don't. Okay. Because I can turn my doctor into a 4-4. That's why I attacked. So I'll tap this to make this a 4-4. Then I don't know, I'll have to play armor, because next turn I can equip it for 8 mana. If I draw land. I might be dead on board. I didn't even count. Pass. Hello, Felbean. Okay, I'm putting three cards in it, one of which is yours. Hopefully the rest is like brainstorm. Okay. They protect the germ. Sure. From what? From? Protection from white. Okay. First thing I do is turning this stopper into a construct that will be able to block the germ and leave me alive. Because remember, this is not death that trample. It's a different type of death that. So if I just block this, I go to one. Yep. I think that's what I want to do here. I can also make a top three. Yeah, I can also make a top three and trade with amoeba. Should I do that? Not really though, right? Because if I draw land, I win. Maybe I win regardless here, right? Let's think about this. Because I make a serve, I make a top three. Maybe I should just kill the amoeba. Because I'm going to lose the construct. Let me think, because if I draw land, I can't keep the hammer on the top turret that I make with this Shadow Spirit. So now I pay 3 mana. Then, no, actually, I can't make a top turret, never mind. I can't make a top turret, never mind. I can only make a servo. Hammer makes his lose flying, though. That's true. I didn't think about that. All right, then I don't think I can win with next turn. Fine, I'm just blocking, going to one here. I don't want to lose the Nexus. I go to one here. Now I'll make a servo. No, I can't make a doctor. I would need to untap this 2 times. That requires 8 mana. Okay, that's another flyer. I do have the Nexus. I just didn't want to use them because I need the mana. All right, so first I have to untap the foundry. Then I have to make a token. And then I untap. If I draw Sigurd as 8, I'll complain because I just played this last turn. I draw an Ornithopter. All right, that's a flyer. Okay, so what should I do with this construct tokens? Guess I simply attack with them. Yeah, Spirit makes so that the Strix can drop me off. Great sideboard card. So I keep on attacking with a construct. What about this servo? Oh, no, I can't attack. They have a Stoneforge Mystic. If we activate Nexus after flying, yeah, but that needs like a billion mana. Okay, we're trading again, sure. Pretty cool game, honestly. We're just been grinding against armor, against that deck. I'll play Thopter, which can become a construct, thanks to the Foundry. A pass. I also have the Saga token, which is very large. And can safely chain block the spirits. Unfortunately, I don't have Shadow Spear in my deck because it got exiled to the ending. What do I have that's good? Oh, I don't even know. That can be a germ. I'll probably just make a token and block with that. I mean, with Saga. What's that going to protect main phase? I don't really get why. Should I make a Token Saga or a Thopter token? I think it's a Token Saga. It's more free, right? Yeah. Can't end. Sure. And again, this is a chum block. Oh, do they if they plow, I can't. This makes no sense, opponent. I guess they don't know how their card works. I'm sorry. Sorry, not sorry, actually. Remember, 5/5 Conjurer does not die to 10/10 Construct. gain 10 life, actually huge. I mean, they made me a huge favor. They removed the plow from their hand, which is important. And I gained 5 life here. And they concede the shame concession. The shame concession after the plow. All right, super long game. I'll take it. 2-0. 2-0. I'll be back for round number 3. Round number 3 on the draw against Time Twister 88. My hand's very good. I don't have the hammer yet. Blue or red? Blue red on the draw. It's gonna be hard to win. But I'm trying my best here. Let's see, if they don't have daze, I have an amazing start. Just check it out. Hang? Very strong. Very strong start. If I wasn't a player, I wouldn't have been able to make the start because I drew Esper Sentinel as my 8th card, so can't complain about this. Well, I hope now is that if we have a bunch of spells in hand, they do don't want to cast. Sweet. Because of the Sentinels. Okay, let's go land, Pure Steel Paladin. And then I can go Thopter to grow it. Let's see what I find. Mox Opal Ancient Den. I'm gonna get the Ancient Den. I'll play Thopter. Grow the Smith. Do I want to attack? No, I don't. My Sentinels, I think, are more valuable than their Channelers. Ancient Den, not exactly what I wanted to find, but can't complain. I'm just gonna make this a 3-3 and we'll see. Ponder. 4 triggers with a single Ponder. And I draw a card. I guess they're looking for a land here. Ooh, my land was Urza's Saga, so very strong. They've been a land, even though they were probably looking for a land, so that's weird. Okay, they're looking only for instant, and they're gonna get flying, or even a bubble. Bubble or an instant will give them flying. Mox Opal. Once upon a time, a modern staple. 80 euros. Remember, this card was 80 euros at some point each. They can bolt one of my sentinels now. They kill my smith. Okay. You can get hammer with Saga. And they can attack me for 6. I'm not chump blocking yet. Wow, they've been wasteland. Not chum blocking yet. Draw. Hammer. Play Paladin. Talk for 2. Should I chum block this time? I think I will. I got an 11. Opal is still 85 euro? No. Okay, this is a 5-5 Merc. They're fully tapping out because of Sentinel. Oh, Canadian dollars. Oh, sure. Wow. I wish I chum blocked with Nexus now. This would have died. All right, draw. Saga will get a counter. Ooh, the Hammeru. Very nice. Okay, how do we play this? On the Nexus, probably. They just block it, right? What a Let's just go do this. Let's go. Turn one mana, Cigar Zaid. Let's attack with a bunch of people. We also want to attack with this. No, I'm gonna make a construct. Attack with a bunch of people. Un, dos, tres. They block one, and the one that they block, I hammer. So now I play hammer. Let's see if they let it resolve. They do. And I put the 8 here. I hip. Put an 8 there. And then I make a construct with Saga, so I can keep the hammer, but if I do that, I lose my paladin, so I'd rather not to. And pass. Sure. I mean, next turn I get the... we won the game with Esper Sentinel. Esper Sentinel was insane in this match. He let my opponent probably not play all those... Like, they played one spell the whole game. Maybe two. Two spells the whole game. In the either format, that's usually you just flood with spells. You've seen in the first match where they force, 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 and things like that. Esper Sentinel, we're the king of this game here. Draw. I'll make a token. I'll get Shadow Spear, draw. Draw. I can even put the Shadow Spear somewhere. Where? Probably here. I just think go Brazen Bar, but whatever. Kind of clicking buttons at this point. It doesn't matter where I put it because I can just move it whenever I want. So. I think what I do is I activate the Nexus. Put the armor on it. Put the Shadow Sphere on it. It loses flying, but I'm going to give it flying again. And then I'll attack, hopefully for lethal. Even if they have a Brazen Bar, I mean, still like drawing two cards and what's happening? Right? What can this be? Pyroblast. Huh. Sure. And Daze. All right. They want to get Delirium so that it can survive. Okay, okay, I'll take it. I'll take your survivorship. Still no Delirium though. Oh, okay, they've been the land now, so they're Delirium now. To drawing a card. I can block a Nexus. Get to 9, in fact. 4 life. And then once again, I don't want to move the... I guess I can move this artifact here. This way they have to spend 2 mana for the Sentinel. But I don't want to move this artifact because then the Nexus dies. You have to remember about that in paper. On Magic Online, it's easy because it's highlighted, like it's red. But on Magic, in paper, it's not red. So if your opponent blocks your creature, then you move the equipment, creature dies. You don't want that to happen. I mean, I really don't know why opponent keeps on playing, but I guess they like to play their spells. Ponder, sure. Okay. Opponent wants to take all the legal action before before losing the game. Respect that. Read Duke's cool. Okay. Now, let's see what to do against the Blue Red Delver. Once again, I'll have the Spirit of the Labyrinth, the Plow. I guess I already played against like the same deck earlier. I'm gonna take a Smith's Opal and Ornithopter. I think Autocomplete is good in this matchup. Opithenero is bad. Maybe I do still want to take these out though. Yeah. Nah, maybe Smith is fine. Maybe a little bit too slow. Let's do this. What if the equipment dies on cleanup? Would the creature still die? What do you mean? Cleanup. What phase is cleanup? How's March? All right, what about this hand? I think it's a keep. We got Saga and a bunch of lands. I usually keep those, even though post sideboard they have Meltdown. What matchup is March in the sideboard for? Or is the Saga mirror match? Stuff dying can cause a second cleanup step. That's true. The was it with the Emrakul and Gore's Vengeance, right? Because you go to clean up by discarding cards, you trigger a second cleanup step. That's cool. All right, putting goes main phase brainstorm. Usually looking for lands, that means. They don't even bin that. And they find the land, so they get to survive here. Gonna go Saga and make a token with a Foundry. Then make a token with Saga and we'll see. We will see. How does it go? Steam Vents tapped. Yep. These legacy decks play 4 bulks, 1 Steam Vents. More Brainstorms. Again, game one, this strategy could work. Post sideboard, it's gonna be harder to work because of Meltdown. They do have Wastelands, so. We'll see. I mean, I had the Foundry. When Ragavan was in Legacy, the blue red Sagavan was a very strong deck and was playing Artifact Foundry. Actually, when Saga came out, almost every deck had the Foundry package, which was proven to be way too slow, and now this card doesn't see any play anymore. Is there any deck that still play it? Put it still far away from Delirium. Yeah, that's true. It plays the ninjas. It played a ninja, yeah. But at some point, this card spiked to 35 euros because of Urza Saga. All right, they wasteland me. Draw. I'll make it the same turn as before here. I should have played Thopter as well, because that can become a 4-4 if my opponent doesn't think about it. Maybe I'll attack with a Servo as well. Very nice combo, Thopter plus Orchard of Foundry. Again, all of these things die to Meltdown, I know. And we don't have 4, so if we're like the Mono Blue 8 cast deals, so. I guess you could say that this is the worst Mono Blue 8 cast, and I can get behind that. But this deck is able to win on turn 2. Like, round up, game number 1, we're able to win on turn 2 if they didn't have Force of Will. Foundry split in Historic. That's cool. I didn't even know this was an Historic. Okay, no Wasteland, but a Scalding Tarn. What did you exile? A Channeler, it looks like. So you play a Channeler now. I think I want to block and make a Thopter here. Yeah, I'll do that. Block and make a Construct. but sacrificing an Ornithopter. So I don't even lose 3 damage. I got a 4-4, a 1-1, and then I can make a Saga token. Next turn. Draw. Why not? I can just play a land here. Attack and pass. I could have played the Pierce Paladin and Hammer, just that most likely they have force. So I just sit back with my Saga. Again, don't play around the meltdown and hope to win that way. I mean, even if they have meltdown, I mean, can't do much with it right now. Take 6. My things don't block now. Don't fly now, I mean. They're on 12. My goal here is to... I don't know. I was thinking no... Now I think about it, there isn't any sort of like Relic of Progenitus or Tormod's Crypt in this deck. That's a little weird, isn't it? It's a little weird, the fact that this blacklist doesn't play any Relic, Tormod's Crypt. I mean, we do have like, what, the Cage. Cage stops natural order. All right, what did you do with Ponder? We didn't shuffle, okay. Ponder's on 12. My token is large. Are they playing... Are they playing a Murky? Looks like that. Okay. Lion Sash's Graveyard 8. Yeah, but you consider it up with Saga. Was that was Jit? Let's hope they don't have a Force of Will. It's very likely they have it, though. Very likely they have it. Whatever. You have it. You have it. They don't have it. We win. Draw a card. That was not very good at drawing Force of Wills, I have to say. Is there any free interaction at this point? No, right? Force of Vigor, but I can play that. Bah. Two. Ed's clap for Mono White Hammer. Exapus, thank you for the 3rd month. I appreciate your sub. Hope you enjoyed the turn 5 win. I mean, it seemed earlier than that, but it wasn't turn 5 win. Okay, good match so far. We lost a... match against Jeskai Stoneblade, I think that was. And then we beat Cephalid and now Blue Red Delver. That's cool. Thank you, Exapus, for the sub. And let's move on to round number 4 with this deck. What's the difference between the modern and the legacy version of this deck? We have Mox Opal, Ancient Den, Umezawa's Jit. and they have a Force of Will, Days, Wastelands, Turn 1 Combat X. So it's not a great exchange, but then again, this was kind of to answer the very many questions about, you know, some people in the world play Legacy without proxy, not that many, yesterday. And if you attend to those events and you don't have the cards, this could be a deck right up on your alley. Why not keeping everything on the same creature? Trample looks good. Whatever, I had the win. Why do you have to ask that question? I don't know. I diversified in case they had. I couldn't think of anything, but maybe there was something. Been considering buying this deck in paper. Yeah, I mean, this is one of the best decks in Modern. Probably it's the third best deck for me in my power ranking in Modern. Legacy, of course, is not like tier, anything tier, but it's a cheap way to compete for sure. March of the Otherworldly Light. The subword is very heavy against combo because the combo decks in Legacy are incredibly strong, and if you don't have Force of Will or, you know, Thoughtseize, is not easy to win. Well, almost Modern decks is Blue-Red Murktide. Blue-Red Murktide and Izzet Murktide really share. Don't share them many. Don't have that many different differences. Yuta Takahashi recently played a beautiful version. By beautiful, I mean just with the best version of every card. He had and this deck is basically modern legal. I mean, it doesn't have Ragavan because it's banned. You play Power Blast because, I mean, in paper, maybe you don't even need Power Blast. You have, sure, Force Days, Ponder Brainstorm, but of course you do. But this is like, you know, consider, Counterspell, similar things to this. You have a Wasteland, which don't exist in Modern. But yeah, I mean, if you like Blue or Murktide, this is the deck. Buongiorno, Bebo. The best cards are Modern legal. The best card of this deck is Expressive Iteration and Murktide Regent. Those are the best cards. I guess you could say Force of Will is the best card. Not sure. Brainstorm? Obviously Brainstorm is a great card. No one can ever deny that, but I think Expressive Iteration could be better. I don't know. Is especially, let me see the format that's legal in, because I lost track of the arena format. Expressive Iteration. It's then an Explorer and Pioneer. Legal in Alchemy. Che figata. Legal in Historic. Legal in Modern and Legacy. Okay. Force is the most irreplaceable card. That's true, of course, because of the nature of Legacy to be like a turn one or two combo formats. In Modern, you do without it because turn one, two, or combo decks don't exist. Or if they do, they're highly inconsistent, so they don't present in the metagame. Expressive Iteration is like the time where they met, where Ura was so messed up in the Vanguard Spiral. I don't remember that. What was that? I mean, I certainly played a lot of Standard during those days, but I do not remember when Growth Spiral was banned and Uro wasn't.
The Bengals have some for
Zeneca Rising. That was what, 2020, 2019? I honestly removed those years from my brain. I don't know how it's possible, but I don't have any memory of 2020, 2021, 2019. It's really weird how I remember fondly and perfectly every event before 2018. No, sorry, 2018 and prior. But I don't recall any of those. I guess because it was all online and I just, yeah, I really attach memories to places. And these were, you know, so I can tell you exactly every PT, where it was, what I played, what was my team. But for the arena ones, of what was the format, etc. For the arena ones, I have no memory. It's not arena fault, it's the COVID. So we couldn't travel anymore. Okay, chat. We are starting this round number 4 on the play with a hand that is not bad. We have the bait Kadra plus Stoneforge as well. Let's go. Plains, Sigardus, Aid. Pass.
Okay, or is this Saga? You want to play a second caller in this deck?
Could be, yeah, why not? Even have Mox Opal to fix your colors. Okay. Opponent's playing Echo of Eons. My Mox Opal is looking at me like, why didn't you choose me? I didn't choose Mox Opal because of Ingenious Myth in my hand. All right, my opponent went for a turn one, turn time twister and passing of the turn. All right, let's go. I'm going to go turn two Stoneforge Mystic for Colossus Hammer. And pass. And next turn, we can kill our opponent, activating the Nexus and then playing the armor from hand.
Playing against the combo deck so they can kill us here. And if they do that, good on you, good on you. If they don't do it, we win. Hello, Reb. You finished 21st in Copenhagen. Very good. I'll see you in Sofia then.
Opponent... still alive here. Sorry, I meant we are still alive here. And yeah, I don't really see myself not attempting to kill my opponent here. So let's activate the Nexus. Oh, ho, ho, somebody's conceding over there. S clap, turn 3, win.
In your town, Sofia. Yeah, congrats, Rubbed.
Okay. With Blue Remark died. Yeah, Blue Remark died. Very strong. I also saw that it came second in challenge in the same list. Okay, very happy that we got the win against combo game 1. The cage stops Echo Beyonce as well.
They can block with a card instruct? No, they can't. Because we flash in the armor after block step.
Let's cut the slower cards here.
What about Pithing Needle? What can this name? Not Lands of Diamond.
Not Urza Saga. I mean, yes, but I don't want to name Urza Saga. I like all these auto cards, to be honest with you. Maybe just remove a land. Maybe I don't need 22 lands against it without Wasteland. I don't get too many white cards, white lands though, because how many white lands I have? 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 12, 11, 13, 14. All right, that's enough. Man, I hate this. I need to cut a card. I don't know what it is. All right, I'll cut a Stoneforge Mystic. Let's go. You were about to recommend cutting the Caracas? I read you in your mind, boss. Yeah. I guess if you play Magic 10 hours a day, every format, you read. Okay, I'm gonna keep this hand. It's not great or anything, but I do have a Leon of the Void. Or is this like I can get me the Mox Opal to give me the colors? Alright. Leon of the Void shuts off one of the main plan of their deck, which is Echo of Eons. I'll start with Saga. Because I want to get Mox Opal, not because I want to make a Construct. Do I need 4 Hammer? Yes. I won on turn 3 last game because I had Hammer in hand. This deck is called Hammer. So yes, you need 4. Buongiorno, Cristiano. Mox Chrome. Okay, on repeal. Oh, do you want to make a Construct? Sure. Planes? Nope. Point goes for the Construct plan here. Hopefully we can beat that plan. This deck top 8 something last weekend? No, a couple of weeks ago. It's just a deck that I wanted to be playing for a while now and decided that today was the time. All right, you're up. The Phoenix Silence, okay. Mox Opal. Ornithopter. Activate Nexus. What do I want to play? The point is going off with their things there. I think I have to play an artifact. Nah, but I mean, I feel like I'm losing this game, man. Dismember it there. I just lost two constructs. GG. Kept a land without white mana on the draw and didn't really get there. Maybe I can cut Cage. No, I'll keep a Cage. Maybe I can cut a Stoneforge Mystic. Yeah, maybe should have brought in March. I did say it was for Urza Saga matchups. Then didn't bring it in the Urza Saga matchups. Okay. Turn 1, Sentinel. Turn 2, Stoneforge. Turn 3, hopefully Paladin Armor equip. PH Elbin, you can check out my opponent deck, made a video with it. You can see it's on my YouTube channel. It's something like, let me check it. Legacy Combo Mangucci. Create this one. Riddlesmith Combo, craziest legacy deck to ever win a challenge, I named it. You can find it on YouTube. All right, so they didn't let me draw any card. Fair enough. I'll go Stoneforge 4 Hammer. And pass. Next turn, if I draw 0 drop, I can equip. If not, I can't equip. Because you need Metacraft to equip. Land Grant. I reveal my hand. The point is, make a different take on that deck, actually. Never mind, it's a different deck. I play Repeal, Narset, Mox Diamond. Okay, what just happened? Oh, they play Mox Diamond. Okay, sure. No, they revealed Echo of Eons. Oh, come on, opponent. Come on, opponent. You found the Echo of Eons? Lucky. Alright, chat, we got nothing. We got nothing except I got an Ancient then, alright. Song of Creation. Wild. Does Echo see much play Modern? Not really. It's very much played in formats with Lensei Diamond. Okay, I think opponent is winning the game with Song of Creation now. Yo, what's Jeweled Amulet again? Put a charge counter on Jeweled Amulet. Note the type of mana spent to pay the activation. Note activate. Oh, okay, cool. Note, that's funny. I'm gonna let my opponent kill me. Funny how we lost game two to beat down, and I couldn't really grasp what my opponent deck was trying to do. Song of Creation. There is a deck with this card in Modern. I guess also in Legacy now. Is it because my favorite deck in Legacy right now? Well, okay, that's the Brain Freeze and that's the Concession. Yeah, I think it's the best deck for me. I don't love the blue red decks in Legacy. Okay. Pretty bad spread of wins and losses. All right, final match. Let's see what we do here. No Modern content this morning. I'm going to be playing Legacy and then Pauper. I'll play Modern tomorrow. Okay, that's a keep for me. Keep. Volt Channeler. Play against Delver. I'm not gonna play Ancient Dead because I don't wanna get wastelanded. I do not wanna get wastelanded. Even though I don't have Mox up. Oh, grab Burn Willows, okay. It's not Delver. Ponder. Any ponder action? No. Wow. Sigarda's 8. Interesting. I'll play this myth first. This way, if they kill this with a bolt or something like that, let's take a card advantage. Punishing Delver. Yeah, could be. Force. Wow. Force pitch force. They're really wanting to force my next spell, I guess. And more forces off the top. And they leave the other card on top. Okay. They only have two cards in hand. Or 18. Draw. Nice draw. Let's play Pierce the Paladin.
And then I want to play Sigarda's Aid. Hopefully I don't have Punishing Fire in hand. But just like Bolt. Or not even, you know? What if you don't have anything of those? Impossible. Straight up zero chances. Ooh, a good old Brainstorm End of Turn. Okay. The good old Brainstorm End of Turn. I don't know about point in hand, but usually you would play Brainstorm in your main phase there, and your past main phase there. But then again, I don't know about point in hand. I'm just saying what usually should have happened, probably. Yes, because my opponent missed the land drop, so they should have played Brainstorm to hit a land drop last turn. But again, I don't know their hand. They could have had like Stifle. Just Brainstorm, look at five cards. So usually you don't miss the land drop. Okay, three cards in hand. See what it is. Hopefully it's just Uro. Then I would go Paladin Armor, but unlikely that it's just Uro. No, Punishing Fire. All right. Hopefully the next turn I can do this, Paladin into Armor, and then equip with my Starcraft. Okay, no Delirium, so I'm still on a healthy 16 here. Draw. I think I have to play Ancient then first. Play Paladin. And pass. My opponent end of turn is gonna play Punishing Fire, is gonna return Punishing Fire, and then I put Hammer on the Paladin. This is how I wanna play this. I keep a Mox Opal in case I find him. Okay, so they return this. I'll let him spend the mana. And then I put Hammer into play. Because with Sigarda's Aid, I can put it flash. So I have three cards, one of which is red. They need to be, the other two cards need to be forced blue card. I hope it isn't. If it is, it's gonna lose, I guess. Green, in Legacy, usually you play green for Carpet of Flower, one of the best cards in the formats, because there's so much blue that Carpet of Flowers is really just a huge edge in the blue mirror match. Plus, I mean, they have Punishing Fire, so that's pretty self-explanatory, right? Okay, so now we have a 12-12 that doesn't die to their Punishing Fire. Yeah, you can have, of course, other cards once you've splashed green, but the main reason is Carpet of Flowers. Expressive Iteration, that's okay. Honestly, one of the reasons why I don't love to play the Expressive Iteration decks in Legacy is exactly Carpet of Flowers. I think that the green piles with that and Andorans and Uro really puts... Yeah, behind, it really puts you behind. Minsk and Boo, yeah, in paper Minsk and Boo, but that's not nearly the same level of the cards. I think Minsk and Boo is a cool card in those like mid-range fights, but. The Teemer pile with Mightening X performed so far? Oh, I didn't like it. I played like three games with it and then unbuilt it. It's still here. No, actually, it's not here. I built the blue-red with Shredder, with Ledger Shredder, but not a fan of that either. So I'm just gonna unbuild the deck now. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I might be inexperienced with the deck, but
I lost to every green pile, like Alluran, Bent, Fur Collar, and then I lost to Jeskai as well. I'm like, I'm off blue. Like, I just love, I mean, not off blue, I'm blue off fair blue. And then I just play 8 cast. I mean, that's still blue, but at least it doesn't die to Carpet of Flower. Hello, DBR. How's my Legacy event? It was great. It's great. Lots of nice people. Actually, I want to do it again for sure. Lion Shash. Actually, this one can, you know, it's not stupid. It draws me a card. Removes a Channeler Delirium. So I'm attacking for 12 here. I can pop my Paladin of 4 if I want to keep with the Sigarda's Aid at instant speed. What happens if I do that? I'll leave opponent 16. I think I'd rather just flash this in at some point. They fetch. Mm-hmm. They're probably just punishing fire me. And then if they do that, that's pretty fun. I'll take a screenshot of this. Flashing in the Lion Sash to exile Punishing Fire. Nobody expects that. I got a 9. Let's see if it resolves. They have 3 cards in hand. Hope they don't have Force of Will. Well, even if they Force of Will, I'm not dead yet. Ooh, cool. All right. Do I want to equip this, Sash? I don't think so. You still have to target, but then you can just choose no here. So I'm going to do this and choose no. No. Now, with Sash, I exalt the Punishing Fire. Do I also want to... to grow this to a 4-4? No, not really. You can go. I'll remove Delirium in combat phase. I can't even block afterwards. If they have Bolt, I still think I can remove Delirium here. So begin combat, and exile the Borrower, making the Channeler be a 1-1, so that I can block them afterwards. Ooh, actually, why didn't I do that in attack phase? Now they can't. Now they don't attack. My mistake, chat. I'm sorry. I don't know what my brain told me now. Obviously, I was expecting them to attack and then remove a card. All right, here we are. I guess they don't attack. Obviously, very common play that you do in Modern. Attack first, they play Enderance, clear graveyard, and block. But I don't know why I didn't know. Still in a great shape here, of course. They don't attack. I mean, I could have blocked. If I didn't attack step, I would have just blocked one of these, but didn't go that way, unfortunately. Is that Tarmogoyf? What's this? Life from the Loom. Returning? 3 lands. I really don't care. I mean, I could exile some of these lands, but I really don't care. I mean, maybe I care. Do I care? Maybe. But what else am I supposed to do? I guess I care. Because I'm exiling things anyway end of turn, so might as well removing some lands. All right, a good 4. We're in second main, so they can't get Delirium now and attack. Two blue. Ooh, is that murky? Hmm. It is. Although, this way the Lion Sash is bigger than Murktide. They have to chump, block both. I wouldn't mind drawing a spell for a change. So they have to chump with both here. With both the Channeler. Man, if that was a huge pond, like, I'm losing this game now. And if I only did it in attack phase, they wouldn't have a creature to chump block with. I'm very upset about this, actually. Very upset about this, actually. All right. I mean, if they play Murktide, it's only an 8K, so... No, I guess I should just exile all their non-spells. To avoid them going spell Murktide. We'll see how that goes. They can grow Murktide with Punishing Fire leaving. That's funny. I didn't think about that. All right, I'm dead to a lineable. Yeah, all right. We punt and lose. That's how magic should be. Punt and lose. All right, good game. On the play now for game number two, I'll bring in the Spirith, Swords. Maybe Leyline in this matchup. Maybe Leyline is good in this matchup. I said I'm normally not a Leyliner, though my opponent, I think they play both Ura and Punishing Fire, so can probably good enough here. I'm just going harder on my... I cut all my zeros, just low my deck a lot. I don't think it's a bad idea to slow my deck a lot here. Let's try this. All right, hold the play. Let's go Plains, Sigarda Seed. Pass. Rug usually doesn't really deal with the ley line, so. Yep. Force of Negation, Pitching Ponder. Alright. Could draw and pass. Pote Pablo. Mm-hmm, 2 mana. Ledger Shredder. Annoying. Annoying Ledger Shredder. Good card. I think I'll play Mox Opal just because if I want a double spell, the Ledger Shredder will be annoying. So might as well just play my spell now. Pretty funny how I was thinking about cutting them all and then I just left some and this just ended up not being what I wanted. In this like more grindy slow game. Well, down for one. It's okay. I'm gonna kill these two. I sent back the Ancient Den for this reason. Again, I don't really care about the Mox Opal.
It's fine if it died.
Attack me for one? Okay.
Crossy guard is it, win the game?
Must have a shit. Okay. Boy.
I'll deal you one infect, why not?
Okay. One red green, what's that now? Meltdown for one again. Sure. Who needs cantrip after all? An attack for two.
They go to three, in fact. I think I attack with my Nexuses. I don't mind if they bolt one of these. Hello, Frankie Fisher. Yeah, I went to Croatia on holiday. It was a lovely week. I didn't go there to play Magic, though, so don't worry about it. I enjoyed some free time. Red, green, Punishing Fire. It's okay, it's exiled. It's not coming back. Wow, double burn? All right, then. I lost everything. Ledger Shredder. Obviously, the problem of having Leyline in your deck is that you just draw Leyline at some point. But I want to say that we were not in business of winning. My opponent with the double meltdown. Again, this is one of those decks that just really loses hard to meltdown. And I like the Mono Blue 8 cast deck. You don't have Force of Will. You have a side black Leyline against Murktide. No, I wouldn't. This deck has Punishing Fire, probably has Ura as well, so that's why I had Leyline. As well as Channel and Murktide. So. Press down. Petty Theft, okay. Sixteen and pass, sorry. Paladin Hammer here. I trigger the Shredder, but if this works, I draw a card. If it doesn't work, I don't, but can't really play around much at this point. All right, I'm just gonna give up. All right, good game, opponent. Thank you for playing, and thank you for watching this league. We almost got there. The 3-2 was the goal. We went 2-3. It's all right. It's all right. Maybe if I didn't punt this game, it would have been better. But thank you for watching. I'll be back for another Legacy video.